It's been windy and flat the last 3 days, and tomorrow there's a very small groundswell coming in. So we're holding out hope that we're going to wake up on this beach tomorrow and there's going to be like waist-high peelers at dawn or something. Which would be a massive score.
A trip west to Galicia. Why not go as far as we can, to the end of the world? We could try and surf along the way. There'll be waves. And even if it's small, we've got longboards.
I'm really stoked, Spanks. It went from being like a windy possible left that I was just gonna have like a novelty surf on to wash away my drive. Turned into like dream vibes. Point your camera over there, Spanks.
Europe is always a fickle place for a surf trip, ruled by the wind. It's a good idea to bring along a diverse quiver of boards. On a good old sunny day. We soon learned the best way to deal with bad waves was to ride them in any way we could. On a good old sunny day. And we had many, many ways. From longboards to surf mats and everything in between, we always manage to raise a smile. Sometimes just being in the van is enough. Some new horizons, a rusty exhaust, a salt-smeared windscreen and the Galician way of life. Swells come and go, and we didn't want to leave a single wave unridden. Luckily, the study of forecasts is a hobby by itself.
At the moment, it's 1.348 seconds. Tomorrow is 4.5 foot, 12 seconds, with a 20 mile an hour northeasterly, which is bang crack offshore.
We established a routine of winding roads, wrong turns, and beers at sunset. That's one thing that'll always be there in Spain. A cold glass of Estrella around every corner. Santiago de Compostela. The final destination for a million journeys, walked from every corner of Europe for hundreds of years. It's an ancient city on the western edge of Galicia and a vague target for our travels.
We're seeing the end point of the many Camino de Santiago's, where people walk from all across Europe to be here on a originally religious pilgrimage, one which has changed into a kind of spiritual journey for people of many denominations. It's interesting. there's just all these people that have just been walking for days and weeks and months, and they all just come here. And I don't know whether they expect to find anything within themselves, or whether it's the weeks and days and months that made the difference, you know? That's what it's all about. It's not the being here, it's the getting here.
We sought shelter and yabbered strange ramblings when the sun got hot at midday. I'd trade a week of terrible waves or both feet full of weaver fish for one of those Galician sunsets. Night times were easy. We were either surfed out or driven to the ground.
Are you texting?
Texting the missus. Hey darling, just had an awesome sunset surf. Waves were average, but sky was crazy nice. What are you up to? And then he sent a picture of me face.
Riding waves in new places makes it all worth it. Of whatever size, and for however long, it's what keeps us travelling on. Galicia is a peaceful place to kip in a van. Although sometimes your sleeping partner can drive you to the edges of sanity. That feeling of the unknown, of practicing a familiar skill on a different playing field. Learning all over again. Maybe that one.
I used to be quite good at my constellations, but now I'm shit.
I say quite good, I knew like...
I don't feel like I
could point out more
them.
Than two. Or more than one. Or less than one. Yeah. Can't remember. It's been so long.
Well, there's the saucepan up there.
Yeah, but there was me that pointed that one out.
Yeah, but I wasn't listening.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to the show. Please silence your cell phones and stay quiet. Your mind is going to be fucking blown. Welcome. Relax, recline, take a Xanax, and chill the fuck out. That's all I got.
We'll be right back. I'm not too sure when Glassing took over a big part of the process. To be honest, the shaping was always my main focus, and anything that could take me out of that zone, I just immediately rejected, because shaping gets so complex that in my mind I was never available to learn more than I could really assimilate. Probably a year ago, I took full responsibility on my work from start to finish, and the aesthetic of a surfboard, from the design to the colors, was always something that I wanted to work for, and to have my name behind of all that process was definitely a goal to pursue. When you have the final product on your hands, it becomes even more personal and warms your heart to know that you built something that you could be proud of. Every morning when I get to the factory, I always need 10-15 minutes to fill the space. It's strange, but I just realized that's what I do everywhere I go. For example, I get to the beach and I need to look at the waves for a little while. I guess I feel the same way, but instead of looking at the waves, I just stare at some work I did the day before, or just look at some work that it's in the process. And after this, I like to hold my tools, especially my planner. I call it the blue Ferrari. I always have my headphones on, music gets me going, and I like to grab my templates as well and take notes on new boards I just made from scratch. I like to feel dusty and not knowing what the time is. I like to clean my factory after a day of work. I keep the place clean. And one time an old friend said to me that a clean room make clean boards, so I still stand to that advice.
Seven-day forecast, subject to change, partly cloudy, the chance of rain. A caller on the phone, baby, can we just be friends? She said no, don't call again. The local news, it's always the same. Partly cloudy with a chance of rain.
Tenemos que comer.